Recently, my daughter Greer, myself, and my friend Jean Markalka headed south to spend a week in Lower Utah exploring new canyons. Greer is a wonderful partner. She generally doesn't care what you do or what the schedule is, as long as she has a pocket full of squeeze packs. She also has a strong dislike for tents, which means that I get to sleep outside and look at the stars. To them, it is all about having fun, making sand pies and drawing pictures in the dirt, turning mud along the stream beds to a jelloey mass, spending an hour trying to go up 10 feet of slickrock that we could easily walk around. Sharing trips with the kids is something that I truly cherish. They strip away all the goals and expectations that we tend to add as adults to our trips over the years. I thank them both for helping me reconnect to that sense of discovery, and I only hope that I can give back to them as much as they give to me. One, all right, over here.
No jeans.
You want me to hold your hand?
No dish.
You want me to hold your hand? Okay. That is huge.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection. The lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it. Look what it's done so far. And what's so amazing that keeps us stargazing? And what do you think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers and me, all of us under its spell. We know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep? And have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name.